day session. My name is René Treuber. I'm product manager at AXAIS Software. And today I want to show you how Metutag can help you creating tagged accessible PDF UA directly from Adobe InDesign. So in general, Metutag is a plugin for Adobe InDesign. It does have, it helps you to creating tagged PDFs, and it tries or helps you to do so in a more efficient and faster way. It's used by a lot of different companies from different sectors, like the public sector, media agencies, insurance companies, and so on and so on. As you may know, InDesign itself can already create tagged accessible PDF, but the way to do so is a bit cumbersome and it's not really comfortable and not very efficient. All the different steps to do so are in different sections of the program, and also the outcome of the accessible PDF is not a real PDF UA document, so not for it's not PDF compliant with PDF universal accessibility. And that's where Metutag comes into the game. Metutag as a plugin helps you to simplify the preparation process in InDesign directly. It also solves some of InDesign's shortcomings in creating tags or tagged PDF. And it solves those issues. It will make your workflow way more efficient. And as mentioned, it also creates PDF compliant with the PDF UA standard. How does it do that? Metutag gives you as one advantage, visual feedback on how your structure tags or your languages in your document look like. So as you see here, you have an InDesign document and all the paragraphs are highlighted in blue, or the headings are highlighted in orange, and also in different in different tones of orange. So you see these heading structure, and also you see lists highlighted in green and so on. So it does have a structured content preview, so you can check if the output of your InDesign document to PDF will generate the correct reading order in your tagged PDF. And also it does have, it comes with keyboard shortcuts, so it's just a tip of click and you will have whatever you need to do with the InDesign document to prepare. And so we have a very quick operation. Speaking of the shortcomings of InDesign, for example, we solve issues with the table tagging, lists that are not tagged as lists, fixing links that InDesign creates, same for footnotes and endnotes. And also we have a potential problem locator built in into the software, so you can check for different aspects of accessibility that are not always right in InDesign. So for example, if you're using hard returns where you actually don't want to have a return at all. So also the efficient workflow, we do that in a way that, as I mentioned, InDesign itself does have different aspects of accessibility. You have to be aware of the articles panel in InDesign. You have to be aware of paragraph styles with the export tags and so on and so on. And that's all spread out in InDesign. And Metutag itself comes all in one panel. It puts together those aspects into one UI. So we come with intuitive 7 tasks guided UI. So you can just go from one task to another, and Metutag will then helps you to do all the all the work you need to do. It also helps you with, as mentioned, the keyboard shortcuts. So it's just a quick, efficient way to do. It will also help to reuse stuff. For example, if you're working with forms, then the form fields can be applied to the output PDF on each export, and you don't need to retag everything in Acrobat. So coming to the 7 steps that we have implemented, some of them just do the same thing as InDesign can do, but as said, doing it in a more efficient way and also using shortcuts for that. So the first task would be to define and review the export tags you have to create it in InDesign. So you can assign them. As you have saw before, you can also use color highlighting to immediately see what is happening in the InDesign document. So as soon as you select or tag a selected paragraph as heading, you will see the color change, and you, it's a very good way to review those work. And also we add some of the not existing export tags like caption or block quote. So you can also make use of them in your InDesign document, even though InDesign does not come with them in the first place. Second similar task is to structure the content into articles. So you need to define the reading order of your stories and images in the InDesign document. And again, you can do so by using keyboard shortcuts. So it will be a quick way to tag those elements. And also we do have a preview that will actually export a PDF and then convert that to a structure view. So as you can see it here, it will exactly tell you which type of content is in which order and which one is a heading, which one is a paragraph, and so on. Next one is the alternate text. It's also, you can define and review the alternate text in Mail2Tech directly. We also have, as we see it, a nicer overview about the images in the document, and you can define all the alternate text in one dialogue. Also, we have a review available, so you can send it to an editor to review the typo of the alternate text. Next one is just a short one. It's the review of document metadata. This is often missed in InDesign, even though it's just a copy of the InDesign dialog. But as this is an essential part of the PDF UA, that's why we included it here, so you don't need to go into any other dialog of InDesign. The fifth task is the language review. You can not only review, but you can also assign a new language. Also, again, with the color highlighting, so similar to the one you saw with the export tags. And additionally, you can set a primary language of the document, so you don't have to choose that on the export process. Because actually, you should do that on the actual creation process. The sixth task and one of the very important tasks for us is the table structure. Here we can tag tables appropriately. So InDesign lacks a bit of table tagging possibilities. So most tables need to be retagged in Acrobat. And that's very cumbersome and not very efficient. So what we have with Mail2Tech, you can also define different header modes. So you can have quick headers, which are rows and columns, which is typically just the scope attribute in Acrobat. And we also have the smart header, where you can define headers and ID, or header and ID relations for very, very complex tables. And also we have layout table, where the table is solely used for design purposes. And then in the PDF UA, the table shouldn't be tagged as a table. So with make-to-tag, you can also set that as, we call that layout table. And for the table, some short examples. So our quick header, and you see the InDesign table. If you select that in InDesign, then you can select the quick header feature. You just select how many column headers and row headers you want to have. And when applying that, you will have the according structure. And on export, we will also put that into the final PDF. And for smart headers, it's even better for tagging complex tables. Again, you select your table, you select the smart header edit mode, and then you can just select all your headers you want to do. Then select the child elements of those tables, and you can do so by just using a drag and drop. And then all of those fields or cells are assigned to that headers. And if you have done so, you can also do it for the next steps. And again, with drag and drop, you can just select those for them. And yeah, that's a very easy work for all these smart headers, for taking complex tables in just a short amount of time. And you don't need to reapply that on the PDF side. And this table task also comes with an overview. So if you have, if you click into one cell, you can also see the assigned headers, and those headers can also be assigned to other headers, as you also can see the structured list of the headers. And the last task in Make-to-Tag is creating the tagged PDF export. So when you do so in Make-to-Tag, we export the document, the InDesign document, with the recommended settings in InDesign. But we also post-process the generated PDF in a way that we fix InDesign issues. For example, for links that InDesign create, they are not compatible with the PDF UA standard. So we fix that. We also apply the Make-to-Tag features, which are, for example, the table feature. So we apply the table tags to the PDF table, as well as form fields, and so on and so on. And all in the end, when Make-to-Tag creates that tag PDF, it fixes it in a way that it's compatible with the PDF UA standard. So after checking it, for example, in PDF Toolbox or PDF and Acrobat Preflight, there shouldn't be any problems found, and then the document is ready to go. And with that being said, Make-to-Tag and InDesign are a good pair. So InDesign itself can create tagged accessible PDF, but with Make-to-Tag, you can create well-tagged accessible PDF, and you can also do it in a way, more efficient way. And as said, you can do a PDF UA. So yeah, just give it a try yourself. You can download the demo at axaya.com/make-to-tag. That 30-day trial is fully functional. And if you have any questions, just let us know. You can contact us at info@axaya.com or support@axaya.com, and we're ready to help.